Christ took away our infirmities and bore our diseases.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus entered Capernaum, a centurion approached him and appealed to him, saying, "Lord, my servant is lying at home paralyzed, suffering dreadfully." And he said to him, "I will come and cure him." The centurion said in reply, "Lord, I am not worthy to have you enter under my roof. Only say the word, and my servant will be healed. For I too am a man subject to authority, with soldiers subject to me. And I say to one, 'Go,' and he goes, and to another, 'Come,' and he comes. And to my slave, 'Do this,' and he does it." When Jesus heard this, he was amazed and said to those following him, "Amen, I say to you, no one in Israel have I found such faith. I say to you, many will come from the east and the west and will recline with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob at the banquet in the kingdom of heaven. But the children of the kingdom will be driven out into the outer darkness, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth." And Jesus said to the centurion, "You may go. As you have believed, let it be done for you." And at that very hour, his servant was healed. Now Jesus entered the house of Peter and saw his mother-in-law lying in bed with a fever. He touched her hand, and the fever left her, and she rose and waited on him. When it was evening, they brought him many who were possessed by the demons, and he drove out the spirits by a word and cured all the sick, to fulfill what had been said by Isaiah the prophet, "He took away our infirmities and bore our diseases." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
We are still in Matthew 8, chapter 8. It's about the healing of Jesus. Yesterday, healing by touching the leper. This time, healing by simply his word. Distance healing. Yesterday, it was the person who asked Jesus directly for the healing. This time, via the master, the centurion, and the servant, paralyzed, was healed. Yesterday, it was the faith of the leper himself. Today, it's the faith of the master, the one who has the authority over the person, which serves as the basis of healing by Jesus, his faith. Kahapon, it's about compassion, charity. This time, we meditate on faith. Kagano ang faith? Faith is a progression. It's growing in faith. So you do not receive faith as a ripe fruit. It's a seed, and you have to grow it, to cultivate it. Kagamoning proseso sang pagtuo. Una, believe. Wala ga-start ang pagtuo sa know. Wala siya ga-start sa knowing. Nag-start siya sa believing. Ang science, nag-start sa knowing. You know first and believe. You see first and believe. You touch first, you experiment first, and then believe. Sa religion, faith is the first step. Believe first so that you will know. So nag-start iyaya ang religion sa faith. So, do you believe in God? Yes, Father. Now, study. Learn about Him. That's why we have infant baptism. Di Father nga may infant baptism, wala pa man na sila gatuo nga. Why? Nag-start kita sa belief, sa faith sang parents. That's why Do you reject Satan? Do you believe in God? Yes. Oh, anong believe nyo? Belief nyo? Amo nang itudlo nyo sa bata. Okay? Bangod sa inyo faith. Faith sang centurion. Ining bata, mahugasan sa original sin. So, believing gid ang una. Okay? Ang iba niya, hindi magtuo sa Dios kay wala nila nakilala. Di baliskad eh. Kung nag-start ka sa kilala sa Dios, hindi mo siya makilala buubos. Nag-start ka anay, sige, bisan doon ko makilala, matuo ako nga nag-exist siya. So, faith begins with believing. And by believing, you know Him. So, another step, you know Him. Nagapati ka, so, kilalahon mo siya. Hangpon mo siya kung sino siya. Ma-establish ka sang relationship sa iya. Knowing does not mean knowledge exclusively. Knowing is relationship. I know her so well. I know him so well. Meaning, may relationship ka sa iya. Adam knew Eve. Butang balon, may relationship. I know my sheep and my sheep knows me. Meaning, relationship. So, believing, establish ka na sang knowing relationship sa Dios. Ginatunan mo siya, excited ka parte sa iya. Open ka sa mga teachings ang simbahan. Wala ka nag-imbento sang imo doktrina. Kay gusto mo siya makilala, karon kon imo ya personal opinion makilala, diin ka dalon sang imo personal opinion. That's why may mga tao gatuo sa Dios, pero pag snowing, wala na sila nag-consider sa teachings ng Catholic Church. Ang ila lang opinion, ila lang research. Di din sila dalon sa ilang research. So, knowing means, gapamati kita sa ginatudlo sa aton. Meaning to say, antes ka matawo, may ara na nga dan nga mga santos, mga teachings ng simbahan, parte sa Diyos. Kaya mo na, know God. That's why may catechist kita, may evangelizer kita. Kaya wala ka lang ga-produce ang imo knowledge of God in terms of mind, ha? Of course, relationship mo sa iya, imo na yung personal. Moved by grace and the goodness of God. But does not stop sa knowing. Third step sang pagtuo, that's why may checklist kita kung ara kadangat ka, is loving Him. Paano ko mahigugma, wala ko nakilala. Kilalahon ko anay siya, higugmaon, pero hindi ko gid siya makilala. That's why hambalya, tihigugma ang imo isig katao para sa akon. Kaya kung ginahigugma mo siya, ginahigugma mo ako. So, amo nang hamba. So, ginahigugma tabala ang aton isig katao. Pero yung paghigugma, of course, is not only a sentiment or emotion, kundi sa fourth step, obedience. Ang pagigugma sa Dios is obedience. It's not feeling. Obedience. Bisan wala ka feeling sa iya. Bisan ba'y kagahibi da? Basta ga-obey ka sa the Ten Commandments. Of course, ang ibang tapos retreat, nagahibi gid, nagatulog gid ng luha, pagigugma gid sa Dios. Okay. Pero hindi na gauge. Ang gauge ng pagigugma is obedience to the commandments of God. So, bisan wala ka tuod yung feelings, wala kaya nagahibi, wala kaya hindi kaya sentimental. Ha? Pero huwag kagapatay, huwag kagbutig, huwag ka nagkunanutira, gabayulit. You love God because loving God is expressed in obedience. In fact, hambal ni Jesus, if you love me, you obey my commandments. So, ang tao nagahigugma sa Diyos, nag-obey. Pero ang tao nagasiling ginahigugma ko ang Diyos, pero siya ga-obey, wala siya gahigugma sa Diyos. Kaya ang pagigugma sa Diyos, hindi feeling, kundi action of obedience. Fifth stage ng faith is not obedience alone, kundi ang ginatawag natin, imitation, follow Him. So, obedience sa commandments, pero gina-imitate mo siya. That's why may another level ang faith. Imitation of Christ. Sa model ni Christ. Saya dealing sa tao, saya pagtanaw sang money, sang power, na-imitate mo siya. Itang iban ga-imitate as like ko. Ang iba nag-imitate kay Christ as pari. Iba nag-imitate sa virtues ni Christ as religious. Expression ni nasang aton, obedience sa iya by imitation. Next step is perseverance. Kung wala ka sang perseverance, wala ka sang faith. Kaya ang faith nag-persevere. Kung nag-start ka lang sa bunyag, tapos nadula na dayon, kaya nabunyagan ka, okay na, wala ka nag-persevere until the end, wala sang faith. By perseverance, you will be saved. Ang pagtuo, hindi nag-start ka, wala ka katapos. Ang pagtuo, nag-start ka, pero gatinguha kagid nga madangat ang finish line. That's why ang pagtuo nag-persevere. After some perseverance, ang punta sa perseverance is communion with God, to be with God. That's why believing Him is sharing in His life in the end. Pero along the way, there are steps. By believing, you know Him. By knowing Him, you love Him. By loving Him, you obey Him. By obeying Him, you imitate Him. By imitating Him, you persevere amidst difficulties. And by perseverance, you attain communion with God. Amuna mga steps, hayang iban, bala naton, pisan kita gani, nag-start lang sa knowing. Wala na dayon sang loving. Iban, ara lang sa loving. Pero wala man sang obedience. Iba nag-obey, Lunes man lang, pero Martes, Miyerkules, wala naman. Wala nag-persevere. Wala, hindi persevering. Kagtungod hindi persevering, wala siya ka-finish line, wala ka-dabot finish line. Wala, pulos ang iya faith. Kaya nahatagan siya sang faith, pero waya nag-mature, wala siya katapos, nagtalang siya. Kita ninyo kung anong pagtuo. So hindi siya yung believing lang, nga masimba ko, devotion ko, tapos na dayon. No, obedience pa. Kaya hindi lang obedience, imitation kiti ah, natinguhaag kita ma-imitate. Kaya mag-imitate, nga hindi lang isolated act, kundi patterns, perseverance, until the end. Actually, ginsummarize na sa purpose ang existence. Yeah, what is your purpose of, what is the purpose of life? To know God. Believe first, then God. To love God. To serve Him, meaning obey. And to be with Him forever. That's faith. Ginsummarize sa four acts sa catechism, pero may different actions in between. Again, believe in Him. By believing in Him, you know Him. By knowing Him, you love Him. By loving Him, you obey Him. By obeying Him, you follow Him. By following Him, you persevere. By perseverance, you will be saved. So faith saves us, but it has a process. It's not a magic word. It's a process. Knowing, loving, serving, and be with Him forever. Kumusta nang imo pagtuo? Din ang kulang nga element sa pagtuo sa aton na hambal ka ina. Diin ka asta sa imo pagtuo. Kabayang magpersevere ikaw. Kamadabot mo ang fruits ng faith, which is communion with God, to be with God forever. Please all stand. Brothers and sisters, let us now present to God the needs of our community. Most especially, we ask for the gift of the Holy Spirit to increase our faith in God. And that means knowing Him, loving Him, obeying Him, imitating Him, and having the perseverance in the midst of difficulties and crosses. Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the church in all places may consider no one a foreigner or outsider. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who govern our civil life may treat every person with justice and equality. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may learn to understand and accept those people who differ from us in beliefs, race, or background. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the elderly, the lonely, and the sick may receive the comfort of God's love in their distress. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our departed brothers and sisters may be welcomed into the kingdom of eternal life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, increase our faith, cultivate our faith, grow our faith, like what St. John taught and St. Teresa, seven castles. Along the way, give us the grace to persevere until the end. You who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.